The LA offense ready to go for their next drive. And they're in a bind early here, down 14-0. Are you worried at this stage or still too early?
You're worried. You're just trying not to transmit it to the rest of your team. You want to make sure that they stay positive. But at the same time, you're wondering, how are we going to move the football? What do we have on this play sheet that can work? Get back to basics is usually your answer. And make sure you find the guy who can move the ball fastest for you if you just get it in his hands.
Yeah, still second quarter. You get points on the board here. I think you're feeling okay. And we remind you, coming up at the half, we'll join who, Charles?
The coach.
The coach, Jonathan Coachman, standing by in Orlando. He'll have stats and scores from games in progress, as well as scores from earlier today.
The coach.
Right, we get slap happy up here sometimes.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain, considering the blitz that they just had against them.
Goff on third down. Then he'll find his target. Woods, it's complete. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts, as he'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. To throw is gone. And he's got daylight. It's a foot race. And he's going to score. It's a Seahawk touchdown. Now remember, this is the number one defense in the National Football League. There's a good example of why.
Shows that they set an aggressive tone, not just stopping the run, not just getting after the quarterback, but the ball's in the air. They treat it like they're the receivers, and they went after that one and took it all the way.
Extra point up and through by Myers, and that makes the score 21-0. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The LA offense ready to go for their next drive. And some dangerous territory. You're already down three scores. A three and out here, or an inability to put any points up. This one might be over by half.
Yeah, and what you also have to guard against is calling every play for a big shot downfield. You know, thinking you're going to get all these points back on one drive. You're not. And last time I looked, it's still the first half. I'm not saying you have ultimate patience here, but you also don't have to go ahead and force everything either.
Second and 10, Goff again. And Woods has it complete. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. Goff, and able to find Higbee, it's complete. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Goff now 11 of 16 through the air. It's first and 10. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Now the Rams will signal for a timeout, their second, as the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in half number one. They come up on second and long, and the pass protection just has not been there this afternoon. He's going to air it out deep for Woods. And this is going to wind up incomplete. The coverage there too strong on the deep ball, and now they face a third down.
An attempted a deep ball there. They didn't get it. But, boy, they're going to need a few of those to actually hit in order to get back into this game.
Good thing they do have a little bit of time here still left in the contest. Decent-sized deficit, but not one that they can't manage. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off near the 44. And he'll take it across midfield and down to the 48-yard line.
You're trailing. You're trying to get points late in half. I absolutely understand that. But remember, it's all about the ball. And without the ball, you can't get those points. They just turned it over.
Now you got to be careful, because that deficit can get a little bigger on the other side with that good field position they just took over with. They'll run on first down. It's Freeman. And he's corralled at the 40, but not before picking up eight. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts. as they'll stop him with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. From the 40 now on second down, Wilson. Open man is Galladay, complete. Now the Seahawks call the second of their three timeouts as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. From the red zone now, here's Wilson on first down. The ball popped in the air and intercepted. Picked off inside the 10. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. The LA offense ready to go for their next drive. And the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it. And we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball. Just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
They'll keep it on the ground again here. And obviously not fooling anybody here as they stop him behind the line of scrimmage. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we send you cross-country to Orlando, Jonathan Coachman is there and has our EA Sports halftime report. The Seahawks with the advantage, and they get the football first as the second half is underway. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Play action. Now Wilson. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. The intended receiver was DK Metcalf, and it's third down. This defense trying to do its part, active hands on that play, but their offense hasn't given them much to work with.
So they're not going to worry about it. On their side of the ball, all they're concerned about, can they create some scoring opportunities and help out that offense?
They head to the line facing a third and seven following the incompletion on second down.
Check 26, check left, check. Check 50.
He'll have a first down past the 40. And he will score. Touchdown, Seattle. DK Metcalf. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Seahawks are able to stretch that lead out a bit further. Myers connects on the PAT, and that makes the score 28-0. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. The LA offense ready to go for their next drive. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot
of
the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. Gone. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. Cooper Kupp was his intended target. Third down here.
The frustration is definitely setting in because they've thrown it to him over and over, unable to come up with a catch thus far.
I think he knew he would have his challenges against his secondary. I don't think he saw a goose egg at this point in the game. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down.
Mike 5-2.
Goff now to throw. Airing it out deep for Woods. He's got a man complete. A big play there for L.A. 42 yards. Now, look, you're not going to be able to get this all back at once, but that certainly helps.
So you're saying 3 yards in a cloud of dust, not the strategy?
I go aerial attack.
Yeah, I think that's what has to happen. And if you're going to run it, you need to break off big chunks. We just saw a big play right there. They need plenty of those.
2 yards that time, a stark contrast from the big chunk on the previous play.
Line 20. We got to get to the box. Let's keep moving. 12.
Mike 52.
Hey, let's get that ball, D. Let's get that ball.
Off play action. Here's Goff. Escaping the pressure right. Nowhere to turn here, and he's going to go down. Back at about the 37-yard line.
Brandon, I think you understand the type of afternoon this offensive line is having. It is a long one for them. Long for you to spend it with me. Long for them trying to block those guys. They've given up a whole lot of sacks, and the speed and quickness that defensive line is eating them alive.
Now a play fake, and it's gone. And he's going to go down again.
We've watched this a long time, and I still don't believe we get it. Third and long, why are you calling play action?
Yeah, because they're not going to bite defensively, right?
No, not at all. I did have a coach explain to me years ago that for some teams, that's how they have to deal with pass protection and their line blocking. But to me, it seems silly.
Yeah, well, they're silly, and it leads to a play action sack. Well, I was watching him in warm-ups, and he hit a 62-yarder that hit the crossbar and went over this one a little bit inside of that, but not enough leg.
And the difference is what?
Well, your live conditions, right?
Live conditions, game conditions are a whole lot different than practice, where you just pop it up there, no rush, no pressure. I think maybe that takes a couple yards away from you when you have to do it when it's real.
Here's Carson. And he's going to take this one across midfield and into Ram territory. A'shaun Robinson there on the stop. On second down now. It's Freeman, and that play goes nowhere. Taken down, losing yardage at the 50, right at midfield.
Brandon, at some point, these defenders absolutely have to say, we've just got to make a stand. We've had enough of this.
Giving up a lot of points in this game, but looked better on that play. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. 4 yards on the pickup there, but it's going to take him to fourth down. Now here's Michael Dixon as he'll kick it away for the second time. And a fair catch called for and made just outside the 15-yard line. A special teams mistake there, no doubt. Just 26 yards officially on the punt. And the Rams will go on offense here with a first and 10. Goff will lead the Rams up here first and 10 at their own 16. A running play here on first down is going to go nowhere as he is tackled behind the line of scrimmage. That'll set him back with a loss of 3 on the play. And that'll make this a second and 13. Now a handoff here to his running back.
But you got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball because they were in a second and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to third and manageable with that run.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively.
Quit talking about it and bring it.
Here's gone. And tight coverage there. It's knocked away, incomplete.
And we just saw another example. These cornerbacks have played tight coverage all game long. Might start wanting to think about a few double, triple move routes to try and shake their guys free.
Because they have, you're right, they have had no room to breathe.
Hey, five.
Four there. Alert. Mike 50.
In the face.
50's the most.
They are going for it. Goff. They got a man. It's Woods. Hey, nothing to see here. Just your standard fourth down gain of 28 yards. And the drive keeps going. On first down, Akers. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. A gain there of 12 yards and a first down L.A. He's obviously a bit of a shorter running back. Sometimes when he goes up the middle like that, he gets lost in there and then he pops out for 10, 20 yards.
I actually asked NFL linebackers if that was true. Do you actually lose sight?
Nowhere to escape and he goes down. Bobby Wagner picks up his second sack of the afternoon. Offensively, they're going to have to figure this out before next week. Seven sacks in one game.
Yeah, and that's more than any quarterback should have to bear. And if this continues on, there will be another quarterback in the game because no one can stand up to this week after week.
It'll be a loss of one, and they're going to be staring at a third and long here. Now, this will probably be the last play of the quarter. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with this third down play as we played three quarters. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Really in a hole here, third and 17, following the two negative plays. A shotgun snap for Goff. Going up top. And that'll wind up incomplete. Bold play call there. Now it's fourth down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. A critical one here if they're going to have any shot at this thing. So they'll go for it on fourth down. Now gone. And the Seahawk defense gets to him, and they bring him down. No luck for the Rams as they fail here on fourth down. And that will force a turnover on downs.
Green 80!
Let's go.
Good job right there. Go. Charlie,
Kill. They'll run on first down. Freeman. And he'll be brought down at about the 42. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight.
Well, they held him to a short gain on that one, and it almost felt like on that first run, they were trying to just throw the jab at him. So how do you stop a jab? Get closer and smother it, just as they did on that last play.
Hey, zero, zero, zero.
Throwing on second and eight, Wilson. Looking for the tight end, Olsen, and it's intercepted. Taylor Rapp with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Now they get a fourth quarter pick. A little something to hang their hat on, I guess.
Okay, so let's face it now. Who's happy about this play? Fantasy guys, right?
Yeah.
The analytics will tell you one thing or another. That's a bad play on one hand, a good play on the other. But it's all about the fantasy points here.
Yeah, because this ball game is over. Now a throw downfield is taken in by his running back. And he'll be corralled right around the 34. It's a gain of 15, and the Rams have a first down. Goff now 6 for 6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's first and 10. From the gun, here's Goff. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. Call it a gain of 3, and that'll make it second down. That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7.
76.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. It's a Rams first down on a pickup of 10. Now a first down throw. Gone. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
So if we recount real quick, he had the touchdown earlier, and now he comes up with the sack here. No doubt about it, he's having himself a game.
Got to imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. Goff now looking to throw. That's caught by his tight end, Gerald Everett. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion and would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Jaron Reed muscles his way in for the sack. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked up by the linebacker, Bobby Wagner. And the return stops just a few yards shy of midfield. They'll spot the ball at the 47-yard line. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And this game comfortably in hand. The scoreboard speaks for itself. But you still got your starting quarterback out there. When do you go to the backup? Let him get some time.
And that's one of the great questions in the NFL, Brandon, because I'm just going to tell you, in the 2015 season, I commentated on 3 games in a row that were blowouts. And in none of them did the starting quarterback ever come out of the game for the team that had a big lead. And in each instance, I asked the coaches later on, why didn't you do that? And they all looked at me and said, just don't really do that in the NFL. We, you know, these guys play, and we just play them all the way through. Now, in certain situations, they will take them out, but for the most part, they're not as worried and concerned about getting them out of the game, and that's always puzzled me a little bit.
On the heels of that good carry by Devontae Freeman, here's first and 10. Now it's Wilson. Eluding the pressure right. He'll get this one to Galladay. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. And they have just about put this one on ice as they've got it here, first and 10. On first down, it's Freeman. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down. This one into the hands of Metcalf. The Seahawks moving pretty well through the air. Another first down. And he's certainly been a huge factor in this one. He's got the 2 touchdowns to his credit. Now they look to him again. He picks up the first.
Yeah, I can hear everyone saying, well, why don't you cover him, double him, triple him, do what you have to do. But sometimes they get locked into such a groove and such a connection, it doesn't matter how many guys are in his area.
He certainly looks to be in that groove right now.
Check, check. Zebra, zebra. Check, check, check.
Oh, Wilson gonna throw. And this will be caught. And the carnage continues. It's another touchdown. Still an important piece of business to take care of, the extra point. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now, as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The LA offense ready to go for their next drive. They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like this?
For a lot of coaches,
be honest.
Don't forget today. Don't forget what has happened out here.
Use that as a game.
Exactly. Take a great look at that scoreboard. Realize how poorly everything went for us today. Coaching, playing, the whole deal. And never forget it, because
you're not going to want that feeling again.
No, you don't want that feeling again, and who knows?
And he fumbled it. It's on the ground.
On plays like this, where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back, because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from it. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Hey, Foxtrot.
Mike's 50.
Value three.
50, Mike 50.
I hope you brought your lunch, because I'm about
to... Hey, Zoom.
Mike's 50.
On first down, gone. Oh, nice move. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. So second and inches after that first down completion went just shy of the marker.
Hey, turn it up. Deuce.
Obama.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. And with inside of 10 seconds, 8 to be precise, we get whistles and a timeout on the field.
Here goes the line. 20.
Watch tight.
Right back to him on first down. Oh, and now he bowls him over. They'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. So the victory here for Seattle. And I tell you what, Charles, this might be about as good as it gets. They were incredible.
Yeah, offense was in fine form. The defense threw the shutout at them. I think they worked in concert together. What I like about the offense was they held the ball pretty well. You know, time of possession, exactly what they were looking for in this one. And that helped out their defense. Didn't have to be out there the entire time. So when you do that and you're out there fresh playing, off a little extra spring in your step, and it showed up in this one.
They had a ton of spring in their step. Impressive victory. So for the Seahawks, they boost their record up to a strong 4-1, and they will head back home next week. Meanwhile, for L.A., the losses are piling up as they drop to 1-5 now. And they'll try to get back on track next week as they head to Dallas to take on the Cowboys. That'll do it for us. I'm Brandon Gauden, alongside Charles Davis. Thanks to our entire crew as well. We'll talk to you next time. So long, everybody.
Going big, acting like they know me, 'cause I'm going big.